Torrent, Indiana. Enduring it in search for credit. Star Wars.
Truly, there is nothing like it. What started just as an independent film became a cinematic icon. Star Wars has taken the world by storm and has done so in the past 30 years. Stories. There have been many stories from the Star Wars universe, but the one that seems to keep coming back is the Clone Wars. The Clone Wars is one of Star Wars' biggest focal points, and it has stretched throughout the media with the likes of games as well as comics.
It took a couple years, but the Clone Wars finally made its way to the mainstream. So today's review is none other than Star Wars The Clone Wars. The movie.
A couple years ago, in a place not so far away, the idea of creating a Star Wars TV series was finally underway. And the idea of the series was to start off with the movie. But then good old George came up with an idea. Instead of making it into a movie, he decided to turn it into a complete feature presentation to the silver screen.
Is the Force strong in this one? Let's find out. This is Star Wars The Clone.
Striking swiftly after the Battle of Geonosis, Dooku's droid army has seized control of the major hyperspace lanes, separating the Republic from the majority of its clone army. With few clones available, the Jedi generals cannot gain a foothold in the Outer Rim as more and more planets choose to join Dooku's separatists.
Something different!
In the beginning, we find out the separatists have kidnapped Jabba's son. Yeah, you heard me right. Jabba's son.
How? You know what? I'll leave you to think on that one.
So the only ones who can save him are Obi-Wan Kenobi and Anakin Skywalker. But...
back! I told you this victory was too easy. We never should have sent the ship back for supplies.
It wasn't my idea to send the ship back.
They seem busy.
Anakin and Obi-Wan are stuck on another planet fighting the good fight. And after the fight, a ship arrives with a new character made just for the Clone Wars.
I'm the new Padawan learner. I'm Ahsoka Tano.
I am Obi-Wan Kenobi, your new master.
I'm at your service, Master Kenobi, but I'm afraid I've actually been assigned to Master Skywalker.
What a twist!
So I thought you said you'd never have a Padawan.
How could you lie to me like that? I thought we had something special.
Okay, let me just get this out of the way. I actually like Ahsoka. Sure, she can be annoying at times with her strange names and or other childish behaviors, but it fits her character. And I know that many are planning her demise, but I think she grows on you. So Anakin and Ahsoka go off to destroy the shield while Obi-Wan deals with a very Scottish general.
You bring us something liquid.
Shake it, not stirred.
After a hectic time trying to get the shield down, Anakin and Ahsoka finally destroy the shield, winning the battle, and Anakin finally accepts Ahsoka.
You're reckless, little one. You never would have made it as Obi-Wan's Padawan. But you might make it as mine. Come on.
Good episode, everyone. Good episode. Yeah. Good episode. Good show, everybody. Let's just wait and see what happens next week. Yeah. Wait.
Anakin hears about the next mission and he reluctantly accepts. Can't say I blame him. But in any case, he and Ahsoka are off to save Jabba's son.
Ready he is to teach an apprentice. To let go of his pupil, a greater challenge it will be. Master this.
No epic foreshadows. Stop. Stop it.
As Anakin and Ahsoka are off to find Jabba's son, Obi-Wan goes to Tatooine to negotiate with Jabba.
Most gracious Jabba has one more small condition. He demands you bring back the slime who kidnapped his little Punky Muffin.
Punky?
I agree, Obi-Wan. I'm finding it hard to take Jabba seriously.
So Anakin and Ahsoka make it to the planet, where we have yet another battle sequence.
Concentrate fire on Sector 1137-4265. 1137... What was that again? Just fire right there.
Oh, and just so you know, Clone Wars' humor comes from the battle droids, which they use. A lot. So they get up the cliff and get into the monster.
It's a trap! No, that joke just makes too much sense. Let's try something else. Yeah. We'll have to do.
Within the monastery, they finally find Jabba's son.
I smell him too.
Tells everyone, this could get messy.
He's a lot younger than I thought he'd be.
Oh, he's just a baby.
This could still get messy.
However, even though they have Jabba's son, they find out that he is sick.
A problem. This Hutlet is very sick.
I'm not sure we can get him back to Tatooine alive, Master.
Well, let's go gather him up. There's no sense letting him go to waste.
I have to say, the whole sick thing really doesn't do anything for me. There's a whole lot going on, so why should I care? As I try to get off-world, the Separatists finally make their move. The plan is, apparently, they want to turn the Hutts against the Republic by bringing back Jabba's son. Or killing him. The plan does tend to get a little confusing at times. Anakin and Ahsoka take Jabba's son on their own, where they go off to build more character.
You must have patience. What are you trying to prove, anyway?
That I'm not too young to be your Padawan.
Ahsoka, a very wise Jedi once said nothing happens by accident. It is the will of the Force that you're at my side.
Qui-Gon!
So the next few scenes are the beginning of yet another battle sequence. I think I'm beginning to see one of the issues of the film. Then again, the movie is called The Clone Wars. What else would you expect? As Anakin and Ahsoka get off-world, Obi-Wan shows up to duel Asajj Ventress.
Chasing after Skywalker. How predictable.
Anakin leaves quite a mess, which always leads me to you, Ventress.
Is there something I should know about?
So as they duel, Anakin and Ahsoka go into hyperspace, Asajj gets away, and Jabba is still Jabba. Before getting there, they happen to cure Jabba's son with some good old-fashioned plot device. And so, they are off to Tatooine.
You grew up on Tatooine, right? So for you, this trip is like going home.
Yeah. Home.
He seems excited.
They get to the planet, but find themselves in a dogfight.
Do a barrel roll!
They win the space battle, but have one implication. And through all of this, there is one character who seems to be missing. Padme is on Coruscant, trying to persuade Jabba's uncle Zira. Oh my god!
I know that you are the uncle of Jabba the Hutt on Tatooine. I've come to ask a favor of you.
A favor?
I cannot look at you directly. Okay, continue.
So, Capote the Hutt here declines Padme's offer. Not suspicious one bit. Finding out a few scenes later that he's in fact working with Dooku. Which leads to Padme getting captured. Again. Meanwhile, back on Tatooine, Anakin and Ahsoka know something's coming up, and they have a plan. And that's pretty much it. Back on Coruscant, Padme contacts help from C-3PO.
Is anybody home?
3PO?
Oh, okay, that makes more sense.
So Zero is captured, and we get back to Tatooine where Anakin duels Count Dooku. I'm going to take this time and say that I've actually been impressed with lightsaber duels. Then again, when can you go wrong with lightsabers?
I'm not doing it. I'm not referencing the Star Wars kid. No. It's used way too many times. So no, I'm not doing it. Don't even think about it.
Hey! Hey, no! That's a no! Get out of here! Get out! Go!
As Anakin duels Dooku, Ahsoka travels to Jabba's palace with his son, only to be stopped by magna droids. Anakin rushes to save her, passes her, and leaves her to defeat all the droids, which she does. Which is impressive. Most impressive. Moving on. Reuniting Jabba and his son.
Dinner time!
You are to be executed immediately.
What?
Well, what did you expect? It's Jabba! But before we can have yet another battle scene, Padme intervenes, explaining that Zero was in cahoots with Dooku, thus changing Jabba's mind.
Senator, you have my undying gratitude.
No, Master Skywalker, it is I and the Republic who owes you thanks.
You know, call me crazy, but I think there's something going on between those two.
So Dooku gets away, while Obi-Wan and Yoda finally make it to Tatooine.
Everyone, get in the picture. Come on, let's make this look nice. All together now. And that's Star Wars The Clone Wars. And I liked it.
Okay, the movie is nowhere near at the same caliber as the other films. But if you're able to take that factor away, the movie really isn't that bad. It's entertaining, exciting, and doesn't have some good character. It probably would have gotten a better reception if it wasn't a theatrical release, but besides that, it is a good setup to a good series.
Now I know what you're thinking. This would probably be a great time to reference the disappointment that is the Star Wars prequels. Yeah. Funny thing about that. I know what you're thinking. This would probably be a great time to reference the disappointment that is the Star Wars prequels. Yeah. Funny thing about that. Okay. How do I put this lightly? You know what? I should probably just come out and say it. Okay. I like the prequels.
No. No. It's not true. That's impossible.
Well, yeah, actually, I do.
No! No!
No, what's the big deal? It's not that bad.
We're all gonna die!
That's it. I'm going to settle this once and for all. Next week, the Star Wars prequels. I'm Tim Deanna, and I've just endured it.
It's a trap!
What a twist!